And interestingly, it looks a lot like what you see in Burgundy, in terms of the red soils and all. But it's very different underneath, because in Burgundy, you dig down far enough and you start hitting, of course, calcareous layer. We don't have that here. It's just basalt, and it goes down. The pH is therefore somewhat lower on, I think, soils here than they are in Burgundy, because that calcareous nature probably tends to drive the pH up a little bit. But we do, there's one district here that is basically marine sediment, and it kind of has a chalky look to it, and that's Ribbon Ridge. And I love Ribbon Ridge. And I'm just finally getting back into getting some fruit off of Ribbon Ridge from two different vineyards. And it's a really great locale. One of the things that I'm doing at Ribbon Ridge, though, is I talked a guy into planting Nebbiolo up there, because it totally reminds me of Monforte. And he was daft enough to listen to my advice, and he's planted Nebbiolo there. And the first bit of fruit that I've started getting off of it is really cool. It's very expressive and really neat. But for the most part, most of the wine growing areas up and down the Willamette Valley are left over from lava flows that came across from Idaho. And so mostly it's decomposing basalt, you know, from the lava. And occasionally you get things like Ribbon Ridge, which are marine and in origin. So while the surface looks like the surface in Burgundy down below, it's very different.